Супер.
Слава Україні!
Glory to Ukraine! Today we have the December 29th. Welcome at the Military Media Center, the only information platform of the Security and Defense Forces of Ukraine. We are starting our weekly briefing on the operational situation on the front lines of Russian-Ukrainian war and the security situation in Ukraine. Today you're going to be briefed by Deputy Minister of Defense of Ukraine Hanna Maliar, Deputy Head of the Main Operations Directorate of the General Staff of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, Brigadier General Oleksii Hromov, Acting Director of the Implementation Planning Department of the Main Directorate of the National Guard of Ukraine, Colonel Mykola Urshalovych, Director of the State Border Security Department of the State Border Guard Service of Ukraine, Major General Leonid Baran, Head of the Organisational and Analytical Support and Operational Department, Police General of the Third Rank, Oleksii Serhieiev, Spokesperson for Ukraine State Service of Special Communication and Information Protection, Volodymyr Kondrashov. Please welcome Deputy Minister of Defense of Ukraine, Hanna Maliar. Good morning, everyone. We are starting our traditional briefing. We have the all clear for air sirens, and it's a joke, but especially for the briefing. But we are starting with a short delay. Today we have 309th day of great liberation war of Ukrainians against Russian occupants. Defense of Ukraine against the Kremlin aggression lasts for 44 weeks and it's difficult for us. The situation is difficult because we have a strong and tricky enemy, but we stay united and we will fight until our complete victory. Our defenders hold their ranks, and now we face the heaviest fightings in the Donetsk region, and the hardest spot is the city of Bakhmut, and it is an unbreakable fortress of our front line. And recently, directly in the Bakhmut city, I was able to witness the motivation of our citizens and our defenders. Forged by steel, our heroes fight in fierce fightings. And at the very seconds of our briefing, there are heavy fightings right now. And paying the highest price against the whole conflict line, we do our feast every day. Every hour, every day and night of their defense equals our lives saved and the lives of Ukrainian people. And right now, the security sector of Ukraine works for the victory. And we still have a lot of work to be done ahead. Glory to everyone who fights for Ukraine, and we are grateful to everyone who helps Ukrainian army to fight Russian invaders. And we have to create our own informational space. We are getting liberated and independent from Russian informational space, including fakes, social networks of the enemy. And please bear in mind that fakes are spread faster than the truth, and please trust only the official sources, namely the Ministry of Defense and the General Staff. And if you are abroad right now, please talk and speak about Ukraine, spread the evidence of Russian war crimes, and remind and talk about the war to the whole world. And please don't get tired and be the informational warrior for Ukraine. The Russian tactics is aimed at undermining the unity of our society, and during this time, during this difficult time, we have to stay united and don't get exposed to manipulations and spread the treason. Please keep calm and believe in the armed forces of Ukraine. Every week we analyze the disinformation and Russian news against Ukraine, and their misinformation continues to spread against Ukraine, aiming at PSYOPs to destabilize the influence on the Ukrainian society. And the regular information about the advance from the territory of Belarus and the total mobilization and other measures are to wreak havoc and panic. And as you know, when we are in panic, we tend to lose our consciousness and communication and critical thinking. That is why please keep calm, believe in the armed forces of Ukraine, and assess the information critically. And every week we also discuss the informational topics of the Russian space. And as for this week, we had seen the myth of the Russian power and other tales about tricky Western countries, as well as other horrors about the war till the last Ukrainians stand. And these narratives are used to launch and have the process of critical thinking. For example, the myth about Russian military power aims at threatening us and our partners and force us to make a pause and give the Russians opportunity to build up weapons. And then they will try to do this one again. The second is the advance from the Belarus is also aiming at wreaking havoc, and this informational and psychological campaign lasts for a long time. However, the Russian Federation did not achieve any goals set, because every day we learn something new and we know how to fight them. The active spread of messages on total mobilization is also spread, and we know that since the 24th of February the mobilization is going on right now. We also faced other narratives that Ukrainians themselves shell and launch rounds against their own settlements to create a message for the West. This is the opposite for the Russian, because Russians do the same things they said we do for the last 8 years. The Russian purpose is to distract attention and make us territories. I want to emphasize that our military personnel take care when they choose targets, and sometimes we face cases when the even important targets are being cancelled because there are citizens and civilians around them. However, the Kremlin cannot do the same, and that is why they regularly try to accuse Ukraine of that. The strategic goals of the Kremlin remain the same. Aggressor sticks to its plan to force the Ukrainian government and authority to negotiations on the necessary for the Russians' conditions. The Russians build up military power and continue to launch massive missiles and aviation strikes of the critical infrastructure. On the operational level, the Russian occupation forces advance in Bakhmut, Liman, and Avdiivka directions. the greatest task of them is to seize the Bakhmut city and Soledar, as well as create conditions for the full occupation of the region of Donetsk. But the more information you will hear from the representative of the General Staff. At the temporarily occupied territories, the Russian invaders spread their measures to wreak havoc, and they also imposed the total 24-hour curfew. This regime is strengthened during the New Year's and Christmas holidays. And we know that the violators of the curfew will be detained. It's also forbidden for Ukrainian citizens who are forcibly stationed on the temporarily occupied territories are not allowed to come out of their houses. The Russian invaders also continue to destroy infrastructure and other civilian facilities. As you know, Russians also deployed remote and portable groups who dismantle and remove civilian facilities on the territory of Ukraine. For this purpose, they try to destroy capital buildings and other facilities and material of infrastructure. This way, the Russian forces try to destabilize the situation and create artificial conditions unfavorable for living. And you know that every week we discuss the issues about material and other supports concerning our government and society, and now we will discuss and give you the information for the last 2 weeks, from December 15 to December 28. For the last 2 weeks, the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine sent more than 38,000 of armor vests, more than 55,000 of helmets, more than 120,000 of winter footwear. In addition, during the last 2 weeks, more than 240,000 of winter jackets, more than 340,000 of winter pants, more than 160,000 of BDUs, more than 270,000 winter hats, more than 60,000 of fleece jackets, and 770,000 of demi season and winter underwear, as well as other material. These things have been sent and processed for the needs of the armed forces of Ukraine. In general, to sum up, in the upcoming year, we'll have the reserve of 200,000 armor vests and 120,000 helmets. As we talk about issues we need for the material support, we closed all the cases, and for now we have hundreds of thousands of winter uniform and helmets, footwear, and supply is still going on. We did not emphasize the summer uniform, but in autumn we started to create the reserve of these types of uniform, and the supply of summer uniform will increase. Just for your understanding, I want to say that as for the winter uniform, 88.9% are goods issued by the contracts of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine. And as for winter jackets, 7.9% are material assistance from our partners, and 3.1% are from charity. That is why you can see the volume of support we have right now, given by the state and our forces. And that is why, by these contracts of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine, we met the large portion of our needs. And the supply issues are stable. Now, we'll discuss about the payment allowances. Now we'll discuss it in more plain language, because during the previous 2 weeks we had some issues with understanding. Our main result is that during the next year the Minister of Defense of Ukraine will have no debts. The allowance issuing process has been stabilized and provided by the payments from our national reserves. All planned payments, including additional payments during the service of the martial law and other issues for the direct participation in hostilities, are being covered. Other payments concerning health issues are being covered as well. Payments relating to dependence of our parish warriors are also is also being covered right now, and it is an uninterruptible process. We also have positive news and information concerning the judicial issues. And during the last 2 weeks, we had judicial decisions to withdraw money for the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine with the sum of over 43.1 million hryvnia. And other sanctions for the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine as well. As for now, we had positive decisions of the Eastern Appeal Household Court to seize the money for the armed, for the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine for the sum of 12.7 million hryvnia. The Central Appeal Household Court took a decision to withdraw money for the sum of 1.3 million hryvnia for the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine. And that is why we are constantly tracking the issues for the proper supply and other issues for the armed forces of Ukraine. As a result of the work done by the Judicial Service of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine, two claims have been satisfied, and more than 21.5 million hryvnia of sanctions have been transferred for the needs of the armed forces of Ukraine. And there is also another victory on the judicial front line, and it refers to prevent the improper acquisition of immovable property by the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine. And on December 15 this year, we had satisfied the requirements of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine to provide 9,265 square meters of living area for the living quarters of our servicemen. That is why I want to say that on this judicial front line, the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine fights the same. Thank you for your attention. We had information of Hanna Maliar. Thank you for your briefing. Now, please welcome Brigadier General Oleksii Hromov. Good morning, everyone. During the last week, the crews of 295MS aircraft of the Russian state launched missiles in Caspian and region and in Volgograd region as well. In addition, on December 16, the enemy resumed MiG-31K aircraft flights in the airspace. These aircraft are hypersonic missiles carriers. It was all aimed to distract our air defenses and engage critical infrastructure of Ukraine. From December 23 to December 29, the enemy launched 22 missiles and used 23 kamikaze drones against Ukraine. 19 air targets have been eliminated by our defenses. Today, on December 29, the enemy also launched missiles and aviation strikes against Ukraine. The enemy launched air and sea-based cruise missiles, as well as F-300 and S-400 air defense systems on the whole territory of Ukraine. The enemy used more 69 missiles. Air defense forces of the armed forces of Ukraine eliminated 54 missiles. The most difficult situation remained on the eastern part of the our Ukrainian territory. From December 23 to December 28, we faced 259 combat encounters. During the state border of the territory of the Republic of Belarus, the situation is stable and under control. The enemy continued to increase its level of training and other issues, and we know that there are 11,300 of personnel and more than 400 units of weapons and military equipment of the Russian and Belarusian aggressor states.
22,000 проти 45,500 окупантів. Навіть у разі залучення всіх бойових білоруських військових частин.
As for now, we know that the
сил спеціальних операцій.
Units deployed on the territory of Belarus in Bransk and Kursk regions are two times less than they had in advance of Kyiv for the first time. 22,000 against 45,500. As for now, even if they involve the Belarusian military forces, the joint task force would state of up to 30,000 of servicemen, and it's still less than they had during the large-scale invasion. In addition, the Russian Federation moved all ammunition dumps and ammunition for artillery systems and other MLRS created to engage Ukraine. At the same time, the Russian party extends its control over military airfields of the Republic of the Belarus. During the week, the Russian performed 21 missile launches from the
на сході нашої країни обстановка залишається спокійною. Противник вів наступальні дії на Харківському, Куп'янському, Ліманському, Бахмутському, Авдіївському та Новопавлівському напрямках.
On the east of our country, the situation is difficult. The enemy performed offensive actions in Kharkiv, Kupiansk, Kleman, Bakhmut, Avdiivka and Novopavlovsk direction. The enemy also performed artillery launches of our troops' positions. In addition, the main efforts were concentrated in Bakhmut direction. Around Bakhmut, the defenders of Ukraine deter the enemy to concentrate its artillery fire. The enemy deliberately reduced the number of shells of our troops' positions in Kherson and Zaporizhzhia direction. Over 40% of artillery shelling along the whole contact line from Kupiansk to Marienka lies in the Bakhmut direction. The enemy also tried to seize Bakhmut and Kremenna. At the same time, we also have information of preparation of defensive line in Luhansk. At the same time, we can say that in case of breach of their defensive lines by the Ukrainian forces in Svatov and Kremenna, and to shift actions to Luhansk, the major part of the Second Army Corps of the Russian Federation, including mobilized ones, plan to surrender. In Kherson and Zaporizhzhia direction, the situation is stable and controlled, without significant changes. In Zaporizhzhia direction, the occupation authorities deployed information campaign aimed at involvement of personnel to get their citizenship. The occupation authority spread information to forbid access to Russia and other regions from the January 1. 151 enemy installations have been engaged by the artillery shells and rounds of the Ukrainian artillery. In Moscow, they are aware that the war will be protracted, but despite difficulties, we will stand happy, the victorious new year. We will win. Thank you to you. Thank you for your attention and glory to Ukraine. We are grateful to Ukrainian warriors for their fight, and we are grateful to Brigadier General Hromov for his information. And now, please welcome Colonel Mykola Urshalovych, representative of the National Guard of the Armed Forces of Ukraine. Good morning, everyone. Welcome at this military center, and I welcome everyone who celebrated Christmas on December 25. Military units and elements of the National Guard of Ukraine continue to perform combat tasks as part of defense forces of Ukraine. The main forces and efforts of the National Guard were aimed at defensive actions within Slobozhansk, Donetsk and Taurizhsk directions, deterring the enemy advance in Kupiansk, Slovyansk, Siversk, Bakhmutskomu, Avdiivka, Novopavlovsk and Zaporizhzhia directions, stabilization measures in Volyn, Polisa, Siversk, Bessarabsk and Bidani Buch operational areas, defensive actions in southern western operational zone. Despite daily high volume intensity shellings, the National Guard fight for their lives and protect Ukrainian villages and cities, Ukrainian people from the bloody hugs of the Russians. on every of these directions, we had no losses of our forces. Thus, National Guard Special Purpose Brigade in the vicinity of Ozaryanivka of the Donetsk region destroyed the enemy. The enemy suffered 26 KIA and 32 WIA. The artillery of this brigade engaged the enemy troop installations and other positions. In general, artillery units of the National Guard performed 400 combat tasks, and we destroyed 3 ammunition dumps, 10 units of weapons and equipment, as well as 100 of personnel. During their tasks in the vicinity of Avdiivka, the special detachment of the special purpose of the Northern National Guard unit destroyed 7 units of armor material and more than 50 invaders. The enemy tried to bypass our positions, but had been detected by the UAVs, and with the use of kamikaze drones and anti-tank units have been destroyed. The air reconnaissance of the Pecherskoy Brigade, National Guard, alongside with the armed forces of Ukraine, destroyed 2 tanks, 16 armed fighting vehicles, separate units of automobile vehicles, 22 dugouts, and the enemy manpower. In general, the air reconnaissance units discovered 267 targets. The National Guard Aviation performed 4 combat flights to engage the enemy. The engineer units of the brigade named after Petro Kalnyshevsky built up their efforts to repair power lines in Dnipro and Mykolaiv regions. The National Guard demining teams during the previous week disposed of 216 improvised explosive devices, researched for 7 hectares of terrain and 19 kilometers of ways. During the stabilization measures, the main efforts of our units were aimed at security and protection of more than 300 important installations, security and protection of state authority 30 installations and 100 critical infrastructure installations. Alongside the National Police, the National Guard continued to perform their tasks in 162 checkpoints in 19 regions of Ukraine, where we involve 6,000 of servicemen. During the tasks, National Guard detained 1,356 persons, one unit of one gun, 1,400 of ammunition, 23 grenades, 5 anti-tank mines, 15 artillery rounds, and more than 1 kilogram of drugs have been seized. During the stabilization and search and rescue measures, on December 19, the National Guard Petro Kalnyshevsky Brigade in the vicinity of Milove settlement detected ammunition stashes. On December 23, Mykolaiv Regiment units of the National Guard in the vicinity of Partizansky and Blagodatny settlements detained 21 citizens of Ukraine who collaborated with the occupation authority. During the search of their buildings, we found 5 mines, 15 rounds and 3 artillery and grenade launchers rounds. In addition, more than 2,000 of National Guard took part in 71 counter-sabotage measures in the vicinity of 13 regions of Ukraine. The National Guard units donated blood in the for the citizens of people of Kherson. National Guard continued to involve in blood donation to refill the supplies during this tricky war of the Russian Federation against Ukraine.
Належним чином за той внесок, який вони роблять щоденно, аби зберегти незалежність держави. Зокрема, 27 грудня за особисту
on December 27 for the courageous service and heroism during the protection of state sovereignty, the President of Ukraine, Volodymyr Zelensky, conferred the rank of Hero of Ukraine to four servicemen of the National Guard, namely to Captain Yashchenko Vladimir Yuryevich, Lieutenant Colonel Osipenko Oleksii Leonidovich. However, Colonel Alarov and Major Sergeant Osenko have been awarded the rank posthumously. In general, from the beginning of the Russian armed aggression against Ukraine, the President of Ukraine confirmed the rank of 35 National Guard of the servicemen. During this week, the Minister of Internal Affairs also bestowed other decorations of the Minister of Internal Affairs of Ukraine for the National Guard servicemen. I wish the victory to all of us in the new upcoming year. Glory to Ukraine. Thank you for your attention. We are grateful to Colonel Mykola Urshalovych, and now please welcome representative of the State Border Guard Service of Ukraine, Major General Leonid Baran. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. I wish health and prosperity to our listeners and viewers, and I want to say that the National State Border Guard units, alongside other defense forces of Ukraine, continue to fight in all directions with the hostilities. The State Border Guard servicemen are steady and retain the occupied positions. I want to say that during the 10-month of the armed aggressions, the State Border Guard servicemen withstood more than 6,000 of shellings, and they destroyed lots of manpower and material of the enemy. Main components of the Defense forces of Ukraine counter the Russian aggression. Air reconnaissance servicemen of our units perform the reconnaissance actions and engage the target. They guide our artillery units on the enemy positions. Now, as for the information about border with Russia, in this direction, the aggressor, unfortunately, does not give up on its terroristic actions. Every day, the enemy shells our positions. During recent time, we have witnessed cases of activity of the sabotage and reconnaissance groups. Now, as for the border with Belarus, the situation is controlled, however, it is tense, especially in the informational space. Belarus supports Russia and provides its territory and infrastructure as well as airspace. However, I'm going to say the nature of Belarusian actions and number of personnel did not change. In addition, Belarus and Russia continue to wreak havoc and they perform maneuvers, check their combat readiness, and build up regional joint task force of the so-called allied state.
Яке було б готове станом на зараз здійснити вторгнення з території Білорусі.
At the same time, we see no signs of creation of offensive
наша
unit.
Головна задача мати сильну оборону на цьому напрямку.
Our main task is to
прикордонні підрозділи і інші складові сил оборони України, які посилюють
кордони з Білорусію, готові
сьогодні до будь-якого розвитку
подій. Державна прикордонна служба
України наростила оборонні позиції в лінії кордону та прикордонню.
Strengthening the border with the Belarusia and are ready to any course of action.
Незважаючи на складні погодні умови. Такі заходи відбуваються
по всій протяжності. We also build up our engineer obstacles along the whole contact line as well as along the border with the Belarusia. We enhance our video monitoring system.
Активно використовуються
We also use the UAVs to monitor and perform surveillance.
Заходи взаємодії та спільної підготовки. Нарощується мінування загрозливих напрямків.
We'll build up many obstacles in threatening direction from the aggressor state.
Що відбувається на території
Білорусі. Our reconnaissance units also work to see any changes in situation from the territory of Belarus. We understand that Russia tried to involve
Belarus
in war at any price, but we will be ready to any course of action. And now about the return of Ukrainians and other measures. It's about closure of all passage points on the enemy border. Ukrainian border guard servicemen continue to perform and bring back our servicemen and people through designated corridors. During the last 3 months, we processed 2,728 citizens of Ukraine. And from the beginning of April this year, more than 5,800 of Ukrainians came back from the Russian territory.
По дорученнях правоохоронних органів для поглибленої перевірки до Нацполіції або Служби безпеки України передається щоденно в середньому до 20 осіб. На кордоні з країнами Європейського Союзу та Молдови
загальний
пасажиротранспортний потік зараз є досить динамічним, що в першу чергу пов'язано з різдвяними та новорічними святами.
Active, but it relates to Christmas and New Year holidays. If we talk about the previous week, during the previous week we had 85,000 in two directions, and recently we had almost 100,000. But this Sunday it reduced to 85,000.
Так, за добу, що минула, маємо майже 110 тисяч осіб, при цьому на західному кордоні в'їзд переважив на 2,5 тисячі осіб та 550
транспортних засобів. Загалом же,
відношення пасажиропотоку
залишається рівним. Пікові дні, звісно, збільшуються
черги на кордоні. Для забезпечення швидкого оформлення пасажирів,
to process the passengers and transport crossing the border during the holidays, the State Border Guard Service authorities increased the number of inspectors and settled the working places. In such days, we maintained the interaction of other countries to maintain the ratio. In addition, I want to say that due to the New Year and Christmas holidays, the general passage rise and ratio in December increased. I want to say that in general, from February 24, on the state border of Ukraine, we processed more than 28 million people. The largest number was up to 50% was closed in Poland. We also see no positive changes that the number of violators crossed the border, especially in Romania and Moldova. In general, from February 24, we detained 8400 of such violators. And in general, we had the most number of violators in the border of Hungary and Poland. I want to say that in addition, and due to this, State Brigade Service authorities performed special measures with law enforcement to catch such people within the country. We also call on everyone who is trying to illegally cross the border that please don't jeopardize yourself. Weather conditions are tough, and that is why it would be dangerous to save your life. And for example, in Carpathian Mountains, there are also snow, and due to this, we had death of violators who tried to cross the border.
По всіх ділянках прикордонники України продовжують відповідально виконувати всі поставлені
завдання із front lines and areas of state border.
На завершення
Ukraine state border guard servicemen do their work.
Присутнім усім нам.
In the end, I want to say that
щоб наступний рік став роком нашої
I wish the upcoming year will be the year of our victory
для нашого народу і нашої держави.
We'll have just peace. Thank you.
Дякуємо. З нами
був генерал
Леонід Баран,
Major General Leonid Baran, representative of the State Bodyguard Service. And now please welcome Oleksii Serhieiev, representative of the National Police of Ukraine.
Доброго дня, шановні колеги.
Good morning, everyone.
Тисячі поліцейських поруч з військовослужбовцями
Збройних сил України, police officers,
головним управлінням розвідки, іншими силами
alongside the armed forces of Ukraine,
безпосередньо виконують завдання звідчення збройної агресії держави-терориста, а також бойові розпорядження військового командування.
And other forces perform their
відновленням та дотриманням правопорядку на деокупованих територіях України.
Perform their tasks in Ukraine.
Заходи на
сьогодні continue to work to maintain law and order on the deoccupied territories of Ukraine.
Наразі на території
stabilization measures are being carried out in the vicinity of 665 settlements.
З метою гарантування належного рівня безпеки зазначених громадян,
to guarantee the proper level of support of such citizens,
and
in order to provide proper police services, we resumed 20 police departments operation, including 10 in Kharkiv, 7 in Kherson, 2 in Donetsk, and 1 in Mykola regions. I want to say that the citizens of the
та повідомити про будь-яку подію та правопорушення.
Can call 102 hotline and report a crime. For this purpose, we created 370 lines for distance reception of calls, and we also maintain the effective operation of operators during the air raids. In addition, we set
163 working places in shelters.
During the war, we received and processed 6,700,000 of calls.
In order to prevent
the violation of rules and law on the occupied territory, on the deoccupied territories, we have 6,300 police
на звільнених територіях, є їх оперативне
розмінування. On duty.
На сьогодні працівниками вибухотехнічної служби Національної поліції здійснено 446 виїздів у Донецькій області, 25 в Луганській, 131 у Миколаївській, 1671 у Харківській, в Херсонській.
Departures in Donetsk region,
25
in Luhansk, 131 in Mykolaiv,
1,671
in Kharkiv and 2,274 in Kherson regions. The police officers of Donetsk, Zaporizhzhia, Luhansk, Kherson, and Kharkiv continue to evacuate the population from the area of cities. They provide assistance to citizens on the ground. They escort humanitarian convoys to the most distant points of the occupied
settlements. Після обстрілу окупантами з РСЗВ «Ураган» міста Гірник Донецької області надано домедичну допомогу 11 пораненим місцевим мешканцям.
А тим, National Police officers performed medical evacuation around Ukraine as well.
Хочу зазначити, що на теперішній час за ініціативи керівництва МВС та Національної поліції
upon the initiative of the Minister of Internal Affairs and
Territorial
Affairs and the National Police of Ukraine on the whole contact line, our police officers saved their lives
on three directions,
and we have four special crews,
White Angels. Криміналісти головного слідчого управління та регіональних управлінь
of the National Police of Ukraine
спецпідрозділів прибувають у звільнені населені пункти
almost the first to come on the newly deoccupied and liberated territories to process and witness the war crimes. Thus, from the beginning of the
виявлено тіла 1116 цивільних осіб. З них 31 тіло дитини.
Since the beginning of the deoccupation measures, the National Police in Donetsk, Mykola, Kharkiv, and Kherson regions detected 1,116 bodies of civilians, and including
41 of children. За фактами вчинення військовослужбовцями Збройних сил РФ та їх пособниками кримінальних правопорушень становить понад 53,700.
Since the beginning of the armed invasion, the number of порушення законів та звичаїв війни criminal proceedings launched against Russian
за статтею 110 на територіальну цілісність і недоторканність України понад 9,000 і стаття 111 з позначкою 1 колабораційна діяльність понад 2,000.
Most of them relate to violation of laws and customs of war, encroachment upon territorial integrity and inviolability of Ukraine, collaboration activity, etc. I want to say that
26, 27 та 28 грудня поліцейськими Харківської області відкрито кримінальні провадження щодо колабораційної діяльності відносно
352 колабораторів.
Під час тимчасової окупації території області забезпечував матеріальними ресурсами загарбників.
On December 26, 27 and 28, National Police officers open criminal proceedings against collaboration activity concerning three local citizens. Now about documenting facts of torturing places. National Police continue to document and fix illegal detention places and torture chambers on the territory of Ukraine. As for now, on the territories of the occupied regions, the National Police found 48 torture places and other spots.
У напрямку забезпечення публічної безпеки
we have
на території України
relates to
організація роботи на блокпостах. На
сьогодні effectively organized checkpoints operation. As for now, we have 412 checkpoints.
У цілому щодо було понад
1,700 of servicemen and police officers.
За допомогою інформаційної підсистеми блокпост вдалося встановити 742 особи, які перебували в розшуку.
Due to the informational subsystem blog post, we were able to find 742 people who have been searched for. Thanks to coordinated efforts of the police alongside with the National Guard and other law enforcement service, as well as territorial units of Ukraine, we seized 412 guns including
як приклад, 9 грудня поліцейськими Донецької області на блокпосту під час перевірки
90,000 of ammunition, 959 grenades and
Калашникова, пістолет Макарова та 136 набоїв. 25 грудня
on December 25, the області, на блокпосту police officers of Chernivetsk region
вилучено автомат, два пістолети, гранату та
524 набої. Seized two pistols, a grenade, 524 ammunition, and one оперативно надавати допомогу нашим громадянам. I want to say that Ukrainian police officers continue to support our people, and thank you for your attention. Stay united for the victory. We are grateful to Police General Oleksii Serhieiev for his information. And now please welcome Volodymyr Kondrashov, spokesperson of the Communication Service. Good morning, everyone. I'll brief you concerning the information about the communication and service around Ukraine. As for today, as for nine in the morning this day, the access for cellular service remained on 80%, but it was before the morning attacks. After attacks, we witnessed the 70% of cellular service covering around Ukraine. The best situation is we will not talk about these regions for now. The mobile operators anticipate the 80% coverage of area around Ukraine.
Указом президента України постачальників електронних комунікаційних
I want to remind you that on November 26
складно забезпечити щонайменше на 3 доби
we had a test to
мобільного зв'язку
provide
зв'язку загалом
cellular service
переліку об'єктів
access for separate structures of Ukraine, namely critical infrastructure installations and other state authorities. As for now, we had issued these equipment and measures to 802 operators around Ukraine. I want you to understand that there are three factors on which the service coverage depends around Ukraine. These are the mining, the infrastructure, electricity, and other issues. I want to remind you that you have to use the take care when you use your internet and cellular service. And we also recently launched the national roaming service. For this purpose, you have to turn off the automatic
мережі будь-якого іншого доступного оператора. Ми просимо також економно використовувати мобільний доступ до інтернету
change of operator
за можливості фіксованими лініями зв'язку.
I also want to tell you to use the fixed change of communication. We also have the joint marathon, news marathon. And please don't forget about the invisible stations where you can get proper information when you have lack of this. we can also have communication there. Now the cyber space. One of the key directions of the state border, of the state special service is to provide communication in critical infrastructure.
Кібератак та кіберінцидентів. Наша команда урядова команда реагування на комп'ютерні
напрямки
тільки з 24 лютого цього року зареєструвала понад 1500
specialists starting from
як від початку року, так і протягом останніх трьох місяців між
February 24 we had witnessed
інфраструктура, тобто в кіберпросторі Росія поводить
1500 of attacks and we also know that Russian are targeting civilian, not military infrastructure. And the main purpose of such attacks are espionage, psyops, and other destructive effects. However, special groups working close to Russia are not able to achieve their purpose, however, they also always try to do this. And during the last 3 months, we faced the following hackers groups: Armageddon, Sandworm, Cozy Beer, Fancy Beer, this is the general staff. Cozy Beer is the foreign external intelligence service, as well as Ghost Rider. This task force relates to the Republic of Belarus. And we also had Hacknet, Killnet, Z-Team, Cyber Armor Russian, and others. Most of the Russian attacks have been focused on the state sector. They also faced local government bodies and other installations. We also witnessed the increase of attacks on energy sector. And sometimes we also face the correlation and ratio of attacks on cyber and energy attacks. Namely, об'єднаних and other networks around Ukraine. As for now, we faced 100 of such targeted attacks against Ukraine.
Під прицілом хакерів також і компанії, які є постачальниками послуг,
Russian also target commercial sector
і розробники програмного забезпечення і логістичний
software and logistics для розуміння sector as well.
Якщо ми говоримо, що найбільше атакують саме державний сектор, то державний сектор – це чверть всіх атак. Решта атаки – це…
If we talk about the state sector attacks, we can say that it's only 25% of it.
Власне, російський кібертероризм, ми бачимо, що він не обмежується…
Cyberterrorism is not limited to…
Так, у жовтні Microsoft…
Attacks against Ukraine, because in October… The Microsoft users faced problems and violators and illegal programs and software in Poland and other countries bordering Ukraine. And now how the Russian hackers attacked us. For the most part is the sending of evil software, and it's 25% of all attacks used by Russians. One of the most important way of attack is to intrusion to international organizations, as well as the attacks on lines of supply. Except for intelligence data, Russian forces also resort to psyops. Such an example of it is the attack against Ministry of Finance in November. However, the fact of this attack was to exert influence on the ministry. And I want to say one more time that thanks to our defenders on the front, on the cyber front line, Russians were not able to achieve any attack. However, Russian hackers tried to continue to exploit the high level of trust of our citizens and have a disguise of general staff and armed and other structures of Ukraine. That is why we ask to take care when you use your cyber protection. Please follow the informational hygiene, and if you talk about business, please contact government team and other units. Thank you. Thank you, Volodymyr Kondrashov. We'll keep in touch. And now, please, I welcome our participants to the podium, and we'll be able to take your questions. Please raise your hand. We have the mic here in the hall.
Доброго дня, Віталій. Good morning, Army Inform. I had
a question to Leonid Baran. Is there any processing regime on the border? We face some issues that some points had problems with electricity. Thank you for your question. Concerning your first question,
we have державного кордону на новорічні та різдвяні свята не передбачається.
We do not anticipate any special admission and passage regime during holidays,
які були внесені
given the
відповідної постанови уряду номер 57.
Given the resolution of the government of Ukraine, there will be no such special admissions and passages. As for your second question,
і відповідно так само страждають від перебоїв в
Not only the civilian infrastructure suffer problems with the shelling, but the State Border Guard Service passage points as well. But we have been prepared for that, and we did our best to have the autonomous actions and self-sustained processes during shelling. But in addition, we have to take into account that we also use databases. We receive from the official sources, and if such systems are disabled, we will still have some disruptions, but they will not affect the general situation, and they are being fixed as soon as possible. The State Border Guard Service database is not facing any disruptions. Thank you.
Ukrinform.
Ірина Кожухар. I had a question to the representative of the General Staff and the State Border Guard Service. Mr. Oleksii, the enemy is projecting weapons and manpower to Melitopol and Bryansk. Are there any signs of the offensive task force? And now I have the questions to the representative of the State Border Guard Service. Are there any statistics how many Russian citizenship citizens cross the border. And the second clarification, we had the information to detain Ukrainians who crossed the border illegally on the border of Romania. What is the situation there, and how many of them have been found? Thanks.
Дякую за запитання.
Thank you for your
після проведеної question. Мобілізації часткової продовжує.
After the partial mobilization, the enemy continues to project their forces to Ukraine.
Відбуває це він проводить такі заходи, як в рамках і заміни боєздатних підрозділів.
They try to do this to replace the and renew their combat effectiveness. Sometimes they withdraw to the rear of the units, sometimes they advance them and use territorial task forces. We check the movement of enemy units, and we have there are no signs of threat to create the offensive task force on these directions. Thank you for your question. As for the passage of citizens of Russia, I want to say that you know that there is a visa regime, and respectfully, the number of Russian citizens, including this regime, has significantly reduced. I cannot tell you the statistics, however, despite, in addition to this visa regime, we also have a detailed control regime when they try to cross the border, and decision is made with the complete search and measures, not only by the State Border Guard Service, but also with the involvement of other services. And now, as for your second question, on December 25, we received information on border violation on the border of Romania. Six people tried to... Six people total, four of them have been detained, and two are at large. Two people detained are alive, and two of them died. During the last period of winter and autumn, we had 10 cases of people trying to cross the border illegally, namely in Chernivtsi and Zakarpattia regions. All of them died. Thank you. The next question.
Доброго дня. Моє питання буде до представника поліції, пана Олексія Сергієва.
I had the question to Олексій Сергієв.
Як національна поліція буде забезпечувати безпеку громадян?
How will the national police will provide security for people during New Year's and Christmas holidays? Thank you for your question. During these holidays, the national police will intensify their security and law and order efforts. The number of patrols and duty guards will be increased. And as for these Christmas and New Year holidays, there is a curfew going on and other measures of the martial law. Thank you. The next question. Good morning. I had the question to Hanna Maliar. As you know, today heavy fightings are going on Bakhmut direction, and why these fights are important for Russia, and why do they try to do this as soon as possible? Thank you for your question. And as you know, the Russians have a purpose to advance to the territory and border of the Donetsk region, but they see no success. However, you know that they concentrate a large portion of efforts around there, and the ground zero of hostilities is right there. However, our defenders are standing the front line as well. Good morning, everyone. I had a question to Colonel Mykola Urshalovych. It is a known fact that the National Guard created the fire crews to counter the UAV attacks. Are there any facts of downing the UAVs by these crews? Thank you for this question. It's very relevant. Indeed, we create mobile groups to counter the kamikaze attacks. I told you before that as for now, we improve the employment tactics of such group, and we also improve the level of material supply. And now, as for the main question, I want to say that the air defense forces of the National Guard are involved in the general air defense system in Ukraine to counter the air and missile attacks of the enemy. As for now, we gather information and analyze it on how to engage and repel the attacks against Ukraine, as well as the effects and consequences of such attacks against Ukraine. As for now, we are aware of several results, and the servicemen of the 4th Separate Brigade in the vicinity of Hostomel using the MANPAD downed a cruise missile. Thank you. And I also heard the question to Volodymyr Kondrashov. You talked about attacks in cyberspace. Can you the main rules and thesis of how to provide security for our citizens in cyberspace? Thank you for your question. In general, I want you to understand that there are no unnecessary attacks and targets for the Russian occupants and invaders, and you have to understand for yourself that even the breakage of your page and account in Facebook can be the beginning of the tricky campaign. If the information have been sent from your account to lend the money, it's bad, but if that information to compromise your security is sent from your account as well, is also a dangerous move. And the basic rules are to change your passwords. Please use the double identification on every social app and network for your using your key, your phone number, your code, etc. You also use the password managers and behave and maintain an adequate conduct and behavior on the internet. And other information you can find on the official website of our service on the section recommendations. Do we have any other questions? Our briefing came to an end. We thank our speakers, believe in Ukraine, glory to Ukrainian heroes and Ukrainian people.